It was so devastating to know that the person that I trusted to be the cousin, to be my in-law, was actually the mistress. I forgave my husband. I forgave the girl. I forgave everyone. I have learned that there's really nothing that happens in the world without a reason. But when we meet today, we speak, we laugh, we talk about stories. We even make jokes about the past. So when you forgive someone, you don't hold grudges. Why not? And he's still supporting the child until today. Even just now, I went to the court to pick up money that my husband, XXX, my very first husband, is still paying for his son. I believe that the Bible says it's not good for a man to be alone. And if you have an opportunity to get married, the Bible says you better get married. And that is what I did with my life. I no longer threw myself away like I wanted to throw myself away. I thank God for the divorce because my husband until today is not serving God. And I know that if I had lived with him, I was never going to meet God. So this divorce pushed me into seeking for the vacuum that was in me to be filled. I just love people. God has really opened my heart to love everybody. And that is how I ended up even preaching the word of God to everybody. I was not a pastor, but every time I go to church, when I learn something, I want to tell everybody about what I have learned. And even how I became a pastor is because I just said, let me help. Until a pastor comes. They did not even know how to call me. It's just Sister Miriam. I preach and then we all go home because I'm only helping while the pastor is coming. That pastor was never found. I found myself being ordained and so I am a pastor today. I'm married to a pastor now. We are both happy. We are so much in love. These things of childishness and divorce things and fighting is no longer the case. We are no longer for divorce. Only death shall do us part. And I really thank God for that.